visible audible? Give me a thumbs up fast if I'm clearly visible audible. Those from the audience, please fast. Okay, thank you. Thanks for confirmation. So I welcome you all for the second session also. We have already covered the first session. We are doing IBQ 100 marathon today. So today the target is 100 images from pathology, spot diagnosis one by one, all our IBQs. So we have covered many images in the first lecture. This was the last image we have covered. So without wasting time, I'm just moving further. So, okay. So spot the diagnosis, we've already done this question. Okay, so in the peripheral smear, you can see the basopholic stippling. This is basopholic stippling. Basopholic stippling typically seen in lead poisoning. Here the answer was lead poisoning. We have already done it. And I have told you the other, apart from lead poisoning, what are the other conditions in which lead basopholic stippling is seen? So the mnemonic was lunatic. Lead poisoning is the most important cause for basopholic stippling. But apart from it, there are other causes also. So we have already done it. Coming on the next question. This is the next image-based question in front of you. Please read it. Then I will mark it the correct answer. Please read the question. A six-year-old boy present with lethargy because the patient is anemic and abdominal pain. Hemoglobin is 8. So of course he is anemic. With increased iron and increased ferritin. So iron is increased and ferritin is increased. You tell me, iron and ferritin both are increased. It is not iron deficiency anemia. Patient is having increased iron and increased ferritin. Peripheral smear is shown. So identify the inclusion body here in the peripheral smear. Can you see RBC? Okay, I will mark the RBC for you. See this RBC. This is the RBC. Inside this RBC, can you see a peripheral? Some bodies are there. What are these inclusion bodies? Are they papillomavirus body? Are they Hens body? Are it is lead poisoning, that is basopholic stripping is seen in lead poisoning, or it is Howell Jolly body? What it is? So you should know about all inclusions of RBC. These are the four main type of inclusions present in RBC in various conditions. You should know how each of them look like. You should know the condition in which each of them is there. So you should make a list of inclusions in the RBC. At the starting of the lecture, in the last lecture, the first IBQ was based on Howell Jolly body. So you should see that IBQ and compare here. The answer here is A. It is papillomavirus body. So only two are correct. Khushi and Manjusha given the correct answer here. So correct, why it is a papillomavirus body? So correct answer here, it is a papillomavirus body because you can see it is a basophilic blue color erythrocytic inclusion. It is a blue color erythrocytic inclusion which is seen. It is seen on a HNE smear. Can you see the smear? It is not a supravital stain. It is not some pearl smear or Prussian blue smear. It is normal smear. On normal smear, it is seen. It is papillomavirus body. And it is seen like a dot. It is seen like a dot. In lead poisoning, basophilic stippling is seen. So I cannot see the basophilic stippling here. It is not Howell Jolly body. It is the Howell Jolly body is seen in splenectomy. Patient do not have splenectomy here. It is typically seen in splenectomy or sickle cell anemia, so it is not the case. And Hens body, of course, it is not. I will tell you the difference between papillomavirus and Hens body. So listen, what is papillomavirus body? Papillomavirus body is a ferritin aggregate. Now the clue in the question, patient is having excess of ferritin. So excess of ferritin get accumulated inside the RBC and form clumps, and it is seen like a dot, and it's seen at the periphery of the cell. So this is the RBC. At the periphery of the RBC, a blue color dot is seen. Blue color dot, single or multiple, maybe two, three are there in one RBC also. So it is papillomavirus body. It is known as papillomavirus body. It is ferritin aggregate. So whenever any condition in which ferritin is excessive, it will clump together. It will form a blue or basophilic colored dot at the periphery, specifically at the periphery. It is not at the center. It is periphery of the RBC. It will accumulate it. So it is seen multiple. There can be single, there can be multiple. So these are the properties. They contain iron. So they are stained with Prussian blue or pulse blue also. They are stained with that also. But they are also seen on normal stain as dot. They are seen. And in Hens body, it is not iron, it is heme. Hens body contain heme. Now see the difference between papillomavirus body. Please see the spelling may be incorrect. Or Hens body. There are two bodies, na? Papillomavirus body and Hens body. Papillomavirus body contains ferritin. It contains ferritin. Ferritin is iron, storage form of iron. So it is pure iron. But Hens body contains heme. It doesn't contain pure iron. It contains heme. Have you got the difference between them? Have you got the difference between them? So ferritin bodies contain iron, and it can be stained on Prussian blue and pulse blue. So now see the question. And why they are stained normally in Romanowski stain? It is not HNE, sorry, Romanowski stain. Normally on a Romanowski stain. On Romanowski stain, why they are seen as blue color? On Romanowski stain, we did not see iron. Iron is seen on pulse stain or Prussian blue. It is not pulse stain or Prussian blue. it is a normal Romanowski stain. It is a normal. So why they are seeing as dark blue color on Romanowski stain? On Romanowski stain, it is the clumps of ribosome which are stained. Actually, what is happening? See now, this is RBC. This is RBC. Now the body contains excess of ferritin. So this ferritin got accumulated in the form of bodies which are known as papenimer bodies. But these bodies are invisible on Romanowski stain. But the ferritin accumulates ribosomes. So clumps of ribosomes are accumulated around it. And these clumps of ribosomes are stained on Romanowski stain. So on Romanowski stain, what we are seeing here, na, these are the ribosome clumps, which are due to excess ferritin. Give me a thumbs up at right heart. So the correct answer here is A. It is not B, it is not C, it is not D. Have you got it? Rule out the other options. Hovel-Jolly body is also seen as a dot. It is a remnant of DNA. I agree. But it can be present at the center, it can be present at the periphery. Give me a thumbs up. It is not that basophilic. Give me a thumbs up. So this is the next question based on the same concept. Same image, a new question. Same image with different options. So which stain will you prefer to see the RBC inclusion inside this? The patient is having excessive ferritin and excessive iron. Again, excessive ferritin is a clue in the question. Excessive ferritin, so this is the body. So this is the body, the dots inside the RBC. So again, it is a papenimer body and you will use pearl stain. You will not use suprachiasmatic stain. Suprachiasmatic stain is used for to see the ribosomes inside a reticulocyte. It is used to see the ribosome network of the reticular ribosomes inside the reticulocytes. So it is not that. It is not Congo-red stain for amyloid and it is not ravenic acid. So it is pearl stain. You all are right. Tariq, Savita and Patel are first to answer it correctly. So the correct answer here is A, that is pearl stain. So should I move ahead? So this is the next question in front of you. Okay. Be fast. What stain it is? First identify the stain. It is a supravital stain. First identify the stain, then identify the inclusion body inside it. What inclusion body is seen? Then tell me the nature of that inclusion body. So you should know all inclusion bodies. So can you see RBCs? In RBCs, this is not normal Romanowski stain. It is a supravital stain. So what is seen? What are these dots inside the RBC? First identify what is the abnormality here. It is Haynes body. Haynes body are not seen on Romanowski stain. Haynes bodies are seen on supravital stain. And Haynes body contain heme. They contain heme. They do not contain ferritin or iron. Give me a thumbs up. That is the difference between papenimer body and Haynes body. They are not detected on normal stain. They are detected on supravital stain like crystal volate. Give me a thumbs up. And what are Haynes bodies? These are denatured hemoglobin or heme. Give me a thumbs up. So the correct answer here is D. Khushi, Niveda and Dr. Tariq are first to answer it correctly. So there are many, many, many image-based questions based on RBC inclusions. You should know what are Haynes body, what are papenimer body, what are basophilic stippling, and what are Hovel-Jolly body. How they are seen and what are the special stain we are doing for them and name the condition in which they are seen. Give me a thumbs up. So you should be able to identify each of them. Haynes body contain heme or hemoglobin, denatured hemoglobin. Papenimer body contains ferritin. It contains iron, ferritin or iron, one and the same thing. Basophilic stippling is seen in lead poisoning. It is in the form of dot, multiple dots covering the entire RBC. Hovel-Jolly bodies are remnants of DNA. DNA or nucleic acid, remnants of the nucleus. These are seen in splenectomy. So you should know the conditions. I have told you a mnemonic in which basophilic stippling is seen. The mnemonic is lunatic. You know the full form of lunatic. I have told you Hovel-Jolly body kis mein hoti hai. So splenectomy, either spleen is absent or it is present but not functional like sickle cell anemia. So these are, you should know papenimer body kap dikhti hai, Haynes body kap dikhti hai. Everyone give me a thumbs up at right heart. So these are the various inclusion bodies you can see. Here it is Haynes body. This is a question based on Haynes body. What are the clues? The first clue is the stain. Here it is not normal stain. It is not Romanowski stain. It is a supravital stain. So something is seen on supravital stain. So Haynes body are seen in supravital stain. And you can see on supravital stain, it is blue colored. So it is Haynes body. That is the clue. And Haynes body is heme. Heme is denatured hemoglobin. So it is denatured hemoglobin. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. That is the thing. So that is Haynes body. So let me come on the next question. Next question. This is the Haynes body. Haynes body are not seen on Romanowski's stain. Again and again, I'm saying it is seen on soprovital stain. That was the clue in the question. So Haynes body ki list batao. These are the condition in which Haynes bodies are seen. So G6PD, glutathione synthetase deficiency, some drugs, some toxins, and unstable hemoglobin. So you should know the condition for each of them. Make mnemonics and know the condition of each of them. Name the condition in which Haynes bodies are seen. Just now I have given you the list. Name the condition in which papanemar bodies are seen. I have given the list there. Basophilic stippling, the mnemonic is lunatic. Hobble-Jolly bodies, splenectomy and sickle cell anemia. So learn the list and how each of them is looking and name the stains on which these are looking. Give me a thumbs up. No, you will not be wrong in these questions at least. So this is the next question in front of you. Be fast. Very easy question. Very easy question. You all can see again a RBC inclusion. You can see a RBC. Inside the RBC, you can see a ring. The ring is in the form of the shape of 8, figure 8, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is looking like 8. So figure of 8 ring, typically what it is? Yes, Patel, Dasharath, Dasharath and Tejaswini. You all are right. What is the correct answer here? The correct answer here is C. It is pernicious anemia. What is this ring? Name that ring right now in the chat box. Pehle identify the karlo hai kya? What it is? Identify the structure. What ring it is? Name this ring. The figure of 8 ring. Name it. Who will name it right now in the chat box? What does this ring known as? This ring. Yes, Patel, you are right. Yes, it is Cabot ring. The ring is known as Cabot ring. First identify what it is. Then see the differentials. Now list the conditions in which Cabot ring is seen. Why it is seen? And list the condition it is in which it is seen. So it is one of the inclusion of RBC again. So it is seen in the condition when there is abnormality in metabolism of iron and arginine rich histone. Both abnormalities are seen. Then only Cabot ring is formed. Then only it is seen especially in pernicious anemia and post splenectomy. Two conditions are there. What is pernicious anemia? This is esophagus. This is stomach. In stomach, these are the cells which synthesize HCl. You know, these are the cells which form HCl also and intrinsic factor also. So the lining cells of the stomach, these are forming intrinsic factor. So that is the intrinsic factor form. Intrinsic factor is required for the absorption of vitamin B12, which we eat in diet. So vitamin B12 is going inside. It will get absorbed. This vitamin B12 will get absorbed from the intestine only if this intrinsic factor is present. Intrinsic factor will combine with this and then it will be absorbed. Without intrinsic factor, vitamin B12 will not be absorbed. Have you got it? So in pernicious anemia, body forms antibodies against these cells. These are the parietal cells. These are parietal. So body is forming antibodies against its own cell. It is an autoimmune disease. So the parietal cells are destroyed. So patient will not have HCl. Patient will not have intrinsic factor. Because of deficiency of HCl, patient will have achlorhydria, digestion problems. And because of deficiency of intrinsic factor, the absorption of vitamin B12 will not take place. So B12 will not go in blood. It will cause anemia. Which anemia? Megaloblastic anemia. So patient will present with megaloblastic anemia and patient will have also problem with arginine rich histone absorption. So it will be accumulated in the form of a ring of 8 inside RBC and this is known as Cabot ring. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So that is the Cabot ring. So this is typically Cabot ring seen in pernicious anemia. So we are done with all inclusions. You should know all 5 inclusions. Haynes body, papanemar bodies and Haynes bodies and Hobble-Jolly bodies. What was the 4th one? Cabot ring. And what was the 5th one? Basophilic stippling. So name how they look. Draw the diagram for each of them. Draw 5 RBCs. Draw diagram of each of them. So Cabot ring look like figure of 8. Basophilic look like dot, dot, dot all over the body. Hobble-Jolly, it is like dot. It can be center, but it is single. Either at the center or at the periphery, but one RBC have one. Papanemar are multiple. 1, 2, 3, 4. But they are at the periphery. They are not at the center. And Haynes body, it will also look like dots, but not on normal stain. It is Haynes body are seen on supravital stain. So that is a specialty. Give me a thumbs up and name the condition. I don't have time to tell you the condition of each of them. List the condition for each of them. So I summarized 5 different MCQs. So easy question, they will give you the image and ask you what it is. Difficult question, they will give you the image and they will ask you the condition in which it is seen. So both types question can be framed. So make a table of it. Give me a thumbs up. These are five different type of RBC inclusions. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So moving to the next question. This is the next question in front of you. Again from hematology. Give me a thumbs up. Give me the correct answer. What is the correct answer here? The following image shows the presence of what? In the image, I can see a neutrophil. You can see it is a neutrophil. It is having multilobated, lobe 1, lobe 2, lobe 3. Multilobated nucleus, it is not hypersegmented, it is not a normal neutrophil. See the cytoplasm of the neutrophil. It contains some bluish dot like structure. Yes, you all are right. I'm sorry, it is seen in Dole bodies. These are known as Dole bodies. Dr. Tariq, Tejaswini and Vijay are first to answer it correctly. It is known as Dole bodies. What are Dole bodies? It is showing pale blue bodies in the cytoplasm of the neutrophils. It is seen in bacterial infections. These are Dole bodies, toxic granules, Dole bodies. The next question is in front of you. This is the next question. Be fast. See, I have given you two images. Before launching it in the poll, let me explain it. There is an X-ray and there is a peripheral smear. See both of them. I'm zooming it out. See both of them. First, see both of them, then look at the options. In the X-rays of the vertebra, you are looking, these are the vertebra. The vertebra are fish-shaped vertebra. And see the image here. Here in the peripheral smear, you are finding RBCs. So this is the RBC, abnormal RBC. This is the abnormal RBC. This is the abnormal RBC. Let me show you a few more. Then your diagnosis will be accurate. This is the abnormal RBC here. Where else I can see? This is the abnormal RBC. So few RBCs are abnormal. Now read the question and tell me the correct answer. The diagnosis is crystal clear. Ye do cheeze mark karne ke baad kuch confusion rehna hi nahi chahiye. So I have given you two images. One is X-ray and one is peripheral smear. So looking at both of them, give your diagnosis. Is it Hand-foot syndrome, black urine, elevated haptoglobin or sphingomegaly with gallstone? You all are right. It is Hand-foot syndrome. So Khushi, KK and Patel are first to answer it correctly. What is Hand-foot syndrome? It is seen in sickle cell anemia and sickle crisis. I have explained you last lecture. What is sickle cell anemia? In sickle cell anemia. In the hemoglobin, there is heme and there is globin. In the globin, there is alpha globin, there is beta globin. So beta globin, there is an amino acid chain for the beta globin. This is beta globin chain. In the beta globin chain, codon number 6 is abnormal. Codon number 6, this is the 6th codon, which is abnormal. So instead of GAG, it is GTG. So instead of coding glutamic acid, it is coding valine. So the 6th amino acid is abnormal. Instead of glutamic acid, it is valine. So this hemoglobin will become abnormal. So the shape of RBC will become sickle shaped instead of circular. Now, when these sickle shaped RBCs, few of them are sickle shaped, when they pass from the lumen of the blood vessel, they will clump together. They will clump together, especially in bones. Now, this is the bone of the small bones of the hand and the foot. This is the bone of the hand and the foot, and it is not receiving blood, and it is a bone of vertebra, so it will become fish shaped. Severe pain in the bone, it is known as crisis, sickle crisis. It will become fish shaped vertebra. So typical in the crisis, the vertebra will become fish shaped, and there are two things. It is known as hand foot syndrome. So two things are there. Number one, sickle shaped RBCs in the peripheral smear. It is showing the patient is having sickle cell anemia. You can see all these RBCs and fish-shaped vertebra. It is due to a crisis. So the diagnosis is crystal clear. It is Hand-foot syndrome. Give me a thumbs up. These are all spotters. Currently, I am taking only 100 images because 3-hour session. Next Wednesday, I will take a 6-hour session. I will cover more 300 images. So total, I will give you a collection of 500 images from pathology. And that is my guarantee. In your exam, none of the image will be out of my syllabus, out of my notes. So all the images from Robbins I have covered. I have taken it on the PPT. I'm working on it. And I will share all the images with you. Today, you will get a PPT of 100 images. So I will give you 400 more in the subsequent days very frequently. Yes. So we will do it. Done. Don't worry. So all IBQs from pathology, I can guarantee any IBQ will, none of the IBQ will be out of my notes. So you have to, for any exam, it is for FMG, INICT, NEPG, any exam, I will decode Robbins for you. I will decode Robbins for you, the complete Robbins. So none of the image will be out of it. So Robbins will be decoded by me. All the images will be decoded and we will do it. Okay. Anyways, this is the next question in front of you. The answer there was, Hand-foot syndrome. It is due to sickling crisis. And the vertebra are fish-shaped vertebra. So coming to the next question. Identify the cell. It is a very, very easy question. Identify the cell given in the question. So you can identify it as one of the WBC. So see the color of the granules. So looking at the color of the granules is dark, dark black or purple, dark blue in color or black in color. So it is a basophil. You all are right. So KK, Vijay and Nivedha are first to answer it correctly. Nothing I have to explain here. It is a basophil. Identify this cell. Identify this cell. Look the color of the granules. Look the color of the granules. Color of the granules is brick red color. Can you see brick red color granules inside it? So color of granules. So you all are right. It is eosinophil. Savita, Vikram and Khushi are first to answer. So sometimes questions are very easy. Very easy. So it is a common sense question. Looking at the color of the granules, you can identify the WBC. So WBCs are of two types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes have granules in the cytoplasm. It is of three types, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil. Neutrophils have pink or purple color granules. Pink or purple color granules in the cytoplasm. Eosinophils have brick red color granules in the cytoplasm. And basophils have black or dark blue, very dark blue, deep dark blue color granules in the cytoplasm. So based on the color of the granules, you can identify the cells. Yes, and agranulocytes do not have granules in their cytoplasm. So you can identify it. So here you can see brick red color, it is a eosinophil. Here you can see dark blue color or black color, it is a basophil. Give me a thumbs up, give me a thumbs up. So here the answer is A. Coming to the next question. Yeah. Easy one. Easy one. I guess again it is a spotter. You have to tell me two things here. First, tell me the answer. What is see the test given in the image. Identify what test it is and in which of the following disease this test is used as a screening tool. So there are four diseases given in the option. Hereditary spherocytosis, G6PD deficiency anemia, thalassemia and megaloblastic anemia. In this test, I can see two test tubes. This is a test tube. There is a blood inside this test tube and there is blood inside this test tube also. So I can see not blood, it is serum inside both of them. It is plasma, it is serum inside both of them. In the first test tube, read the newspaper from the back. Can you see? Can you see? I can see the letters in the first test tube. It is transparent, somewhat transparent. So I can read some letters. I can read some letters on the newspaper behind. In the second test tube, it is opaque. I cannot read anything. So this test is negative because this is normal and this is positive, opacification of the blood because of increased turbidity of the blood. It happens due to hemolysis of the blood. So RBC has got hemolyzed and it is causing turbidity in the blood and the blood becomes opaque. So I can't read newspaper. So name of test, who will write the name of the test? The correct answer here is thalassemia. It is used as a, this test is used as a screening for thalassemia. Vikram, Savita and doctor are first to answer it correctly. The correct answer here is thalassemia. Name the test. Yes. So Savita, Vikram and Dhruvin are first to answer it. The name of the test is Nestrop. What is the full form of Nestrop? What is the full form of Nestrop? It is naked eye osmotic fragility test. Nestrop. Osmotic fragility test. RBC osmotic fragility test. So it is seen. So naked eye single tube osmotic fragility test. So that is Nestrop. That is Nestrop test. Give me a thumbs up. So you are seeing with naked eye now. You don't require microscope. So it is a naked eye test, number one. So naked eye single test tube. In a single test tube, we can make the diagnosis. So naked eye single test tube osmotic fragility test. In thalassemia, the osmotic fragility of the RBCs is more. They are more fragile. So they just rupture. They just undergo hemolysis. Because of hemolysis, the blood is becoming opaque here. So there is opacification. Notice the control sample on the right side. The fine print of the newspaper can be seen. But notice the other test tube on the left hand side. Here, turbidity is more because of opacification of the sample. So fine print of the newspaper cannot be read. This test is highly used as a screening test for thalassemia. Confirmatory is chromatography. It is screening test. It is not a confirmatory test. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone. Typical diagram. You will get a newspaper in the back hand and you will get two test tubes. Two test tubes. In one, both of them contain serum. Both of them. In one of the test tubes, you can read the newspaper from behind. In other test tube, it is opaque. You cannot read the newspaper. The name of the test is Nestrop test. You should know the full form and you should know the principle and you should know when it is positive. It is positive in thalassemia and it is a screening test. It is not a diagnostic test. So I have told you 10 MCQs based on this image. So what is this test? In which disease it is used? Is it screening test or diagnostic test? What is the principle of this test? So is it osmotic fragility increasing or decreasing? So there are many MCQs which can be framed from the same image. Image is same. Questions can be different. Everyone give me a thumbs up. The correct answer here is C. Correct answer here is C. I'm moving ahead. The next question. Next question. I'm sorry, something happened. Just a second. Okay. So this is the next question in front of you. This is the next question. Patient is having multiple myeloma. Mark it. mark it. What is this M spike? What is this M spike? So the patient is having multiple myeloma. Patient is having multiple myeloma. So we in multiple myeloma patient, when we do the electrophoresis, we get an additional spike known as M spike. So you all are right. It is gamma globulin spike. So Manjusha, Dhruvin and Khushi are first to answer it correctly. We know humans have proteins. This is the blood vessel. In blood vessel, we have multiple proteins. We have albumin. We have globulin. The globulin are of three types, alpha, beta and gamma. Alpha, beta and gamma. Alpha is of two types, alpha 1 and alpha 2. Alpha 1, alpha 2, beta, gamma. These are globulins. Apart from globulin, we have albumin. Albumin, no further types. So these are the various types of protein. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 types of proteins are present in blood. So what is happening in multiple myeloma? In multiple myeloma, what is the problem? The plasma cells, B cells become abnormal. So plasma cells are abnormal. B cells se plasma cell banenge, wo abnormal banenge. They will form abnormal antibodies. Normal antibodies have two light chains, two heavy chains. But here plasma cells form only light chains, no heavy chains. So only light chains are formed, no heavy chains. So these are abnormal proteins. Actually, all antibodies are immunoglobulin. Globulin, it is not albumin. It is gamma globulin. It is not alpha globulin. It is not beta globulin. It is gamma globulin. So plasma cells form excessive light chains, means excessive gamma globulin. So here you will find a spike if you do the electrophoresis. This is a gamma globulin spike and it is due to light chain, abnormal light chain which is formed in multiple myeloma. You should know the principle behind it. Okay, question to solve ho gaya. Sabko pata hota hai gamma globulin. Lekin puri story batao na. Gamma globulin to rest of the globulin ka kya hota hai? So albumin, alpha globulin, beta globulin, gamma globulin. Immunoglobulins are made up of gamma globulins. And in multiple myeloma, there is a problem with immunoglobulin. Abnormal immunoglobulins are formed. Only light chains are formed, heavy chains are missing. So those light chains are gamma globulin. So excessive light chains, so excessive gamma globulin. Alpha, beta, globulin and albumin are normal. They are not abnormal. Only gamma globulin is raised. So you can see alpha 1 globulin is normal, beta 1, alpha 2 is normal, beta is normal and albumin, this is normal. Albumin is the highest. It is also normal, this peak. But this peak is abnormal. This peak is abnormal. It is not seen in normal inside you. You will not find this peak. You will find a small gamma globulin. Here it is enlarged because the patient is having multiple myeloma. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So electrophoresis, again a potential area for IBQs. So this is electrophoresis. This is electrophoresis for multiple myeloma. You should know electrophoresis for all anemias, especially thalassemia, the various types of thalassemia. Now thalassemia is alpha thalassemia and beta thalassemia. In alpha thalassemia, what is the hemoglobin? You should know the hemoglobin structure for each of them. And in the fetal hemoglobin is there in both of them. In alpha thalassemia, fetal hemoglobin concentration is more. In beta, it is less. And normally, it is only less than 1% or 2% normal fetal hemoglobin. So in electrophoresis, you will get various hemoglobin levels. I don't have this set right now, but later I will give this set of electrophoresis separately. Many IBQs are there on electrophoresis. You should understand electrophoresis. It is very easy. It is very easy. If you know the concept, it is easy. So coming to the next question ahead, this is the next question in front of you. First, read the question, then I will launch the poll. Do you want to see the image separately? I will show you the image separately also. No, I don't have the image separately. I'm sorry. You have to see the image here only. So read the question. There's a clue in the question. See the age, 66 year. Age is always a clue. 66 year old woman with polyuria. Fatig, polyuria, kidneys non-functional, renal failure is there, fatig, anemia is there. Take the cues. Polyuria bata raha hai ki patient ko renal failure hai. Fatig bata raha hai patient ko anemia hai. Having two bouts of pneumonia, infection, recurrent infection, two bouts, recurrent infection. So WBC are less, they are non-functional at least. They are not less, they are non-functional. So pneumonia is there or antibodies are not functional. So that is the clue. A pathological fracture is there. So something problem with the calcium. Some problem with the calcium, the bones are weak. So fracture is there, pathological fracture is there and multiple lytic bone lesions. So the diagnosis is clear now, multiple lytic bone lesions. Creatinine is raised. We have seen polyuria bhi tha. Polyuria tha and creatinine is raised. So renal failure is there and nephrotic range proteinuria. So renal failure again and again. So renal failure, fracture, anemia, recurrent infection. Four clues in the question I gathered. What I gathered, patient is having anemia because of fatigue. Patient is having recurrent infection. I have gathered. Patient is having renal failure. Number one, polyuria is there. Number two, creatinine is raised. Number three, proteinuria, nephrotic range protein. Teen cheezon se pata chala hai renal failure hai. And number four, multiple lytic lesions. Give me a thumbs up. So based on it, this is the diagram. I will zoom in the diagram. This is the diagram in front of you. See all cells. Okay, you all are right. those who have not got it, let me explain for those. So this is the cell. You can see these are the cells. In all the cells, see the nucleus. Nucleus is eccentric. It is towards the periphery. See, this is the cell. This is the nucleus. It is eccentric. See, this is the cell. This is the nucleus. So in all the cells, you can see the nucleus is eccentric. So eccentric nucleus, typical of plasma cell. Plasma cell. So all cells are plasma cells. So the blood is filled with plasma cells. See any of them. The nucleus is eccentric. Concentrate on the nucleus. So in plasma cell, the nucleus is at the eccentric. It is not at the center. So this is a typical diagram of plasma cell. Normal blood have plasma cell. My blood, you blood. But it is less than 5%. It is less than. Here all the cells are plasma cells. So plasma cells are increased. So what is the diagnosis? Now who will tell me the diagnosis? Write down in the chat box. So you all are right. You have already answered it. Savita, Vikram, Dhruvin. Anyone else? So you are right. Apart from these three students, anyone want to answer it? Yes, of course, it is multiple myeloma. Everything is paving towards it. So in multiple myeloma, we have renal failure, we have anemia, we have recurrent infection, we have bony lytic lesions, and we have plasma cell abnormality. So all the cells are plasma cells. Typical diagram of multiple myeloma. What is the cause of the fracture and why the patient is having proteinuria? Two more questions for you. So yes, it is multiple myeloma. MCQ can be framed on any of them. I'm giving you the image. I can frame 10 MCQs right in front of you on this image, on this clinical scenario. So MCQ to kuch bhi ban jayega. You should know the concept. So the answer here is multiple myeloma. The clues in the questions, you can see if any specimen contain more than 30% of the cells are plasma cells, it is multiple myeloma. So the cutoff is 30. I can see most of the cells here are plasma cells. See, if it is more than 30, ab count nahi karenge hum andaze pe. It is like andaza hoga ki most of the cells are plasma cells, so they are more than 30% in the smear, so it is multiple myeloma. So the cutoff is 30% according to WHO. Learn that. Why the patient is having fracture here? Because multiple myeloma, the plasma cells which become abnormal here, these cells are not normal, these are abnormal plasma cells. They will secrete a molecule from it, they will secrete a factor from it that will stimulate osteoclast. Those factors will stimulate osteoclast, and osteoclast absorb bone. So in the blood, multiple abnormal plasma cells are there. So multiple this factor, the name of this factor is this, RANKL. The name of the factor is RANKL. What is the full form of RANKL? Receptor activator of NF-beta. Receptor activator of NF-K-beta ligand. So that is RANKL. So abnormal plasma cells are secreting RANKL. RANKL. Learn this RANKL for MCQs. Huh? So this RANKL is stimulating osteoclast, and osteoclast is absorbing bone. So patient is having fracture, number one, and multiple lytic lesions on x-ray. Give me a thumbs up. So how many MCQs you can frame on this image? In this image, I can frame an MCQ on RANKL. I can frame an MCQ on the diagnosis. Simple. Agar mujhe simple banana hoga, to main multiple diagnosis puch lungi. That is multiple myeloma. That is the most simple question. Aur mujhe thoda difficult banana hoga, to main RANKL pe question frame karungi. I will frame a question on RANKL. This is the scenario. What is the cause of fracture in this patient? So I will give you multiple options, and RANKL will be the one of them. So I can frame multiple questions on them. Give me a thumbs up. Have you got it? I can frame a question on Benz-Jones protein. What's the cause of proteinuria? Patient is having acute renal failure. Now, which protein is coming out? As I have told you, this plasma cell become abnormal. Normal plasma cells form immunoglobulin having two light chain, two heavy chain. This abnormal plasma cell will form an abnormal immunoglobulin, which is only light chain. There is no heavy chain. So multiple light chain combined together. Multiple light chain combined together, and they form a protein known as Benz-Jones protein. And this Benz-Jones protein is coming in urine. That is proteinuria. So that is the cause of proteinuria here. That is Benz-Jones protein. So excessive light chain produced by the myeloma cells, abnormal plasma cells, they will form Benz-Jones protein, and they will be secreted in the urine more than 6 gram per deciliter. That is the cause of proteinuria. So I can frame an MCQ on Benz-Jones protein. So same question, same image, I can frame multiple MCQs based on it. What is the diagnosis? What is the cause of the fracture? What is the cause of proteinuria? I can frame 4 options. Done. You should know the concept. If you know the concept, any MCQ you can crack it. So don't learn MCQ. Understand the concept. Give me a thumbs up. Have you understood this image completely? Should I proceed ahead? Give me a thumbs up. If I'm asking for something, be specific. Give me a thumbs up. Fast. This is the next question in front of you. Easy one. So something is shown by the arrows. Look at the arrows in the image. Look at this thing. Look at this thing. What it is? So multiple RBCs are combining with each other, forming a train. Forming a train-like structure. What it is? It is Rowlett's formation. You all are right. Most of you are right. Dr. Tarek, Savita, and Sweetie are first to answer it correctly. Very good. It is Rowlett's formation. it is Rowlatt. So something is shown. Yeah, it is microcystic hypochromic cell. Me, मुझे कुछ कुछ दिख रहा है, but the one which is marked by the arrow, that is Rowlatt. That is Rowlatt. That is not sickling. That is not hemolysis. That is Rowlatt. Can you see? Multiple RBCs are combining with each other. That is now. This is the most simple MCQ which can be framed on this image. In this image, what the thing that is marked by arrow? So RBCs are stacked with each other. Yes, Dr. Tariq. So it is known as Rowlatt formation. It is the most simple MCQ. MCQ will be more difficult. Name the condition in which Rowlatt formation is seen. It is Rowlatt. Blind person को भी दिखेगा कि वो Rowlatt है. Everyone knows. It is a silly question. It is Rowlatt. Yes. Dhruvin, Dr. Tariq, you are right. Name the condition in which it is seen. Name the condition. So yes, it is multiple myeloma. It is seen in multiple myeloma. तो ये second level का question हुआ. Easiest question है कि ये क्या है? It is Rowlatt. Second difficult question है कि ये किसमें होता है? तो answer is multiple myeloma. Most difficult question. Why it is happening in multiple myeloma? Tell me the mechanism. In multiple myeloma, actually what is happening? Actually, what is happening, which is causing this Rowlatt formation? Can anyone explain why it is happening? So what it is Rowlatt. In which condition it is formed? In multiple myeloma. Why it is formed in multiple myeloma? In multiple myeloma, I have told you there are abnormal plasma cells. The plasma cells are abnormal. Done. So, you know, okay. So these are the abnormal plasma cells. These abnormal plasma cells are forming abnormal immunoglobulin, which contains only light chain. They do not contain heavy chain. So these are globulins. These are abnormal globulins. These are abnormal globulins and these are positively charged. These are positively charged. And this is the RBC. This is the RBC in the blood. Normally RBC inside you, inside me, inside all of us, they are negatively charged. And because all of them are negatively charged, they repel each other. They repel each other. They do not come close to each other. Negative, negative repulsion. So inside my blood, your blood, inside normal human blood, RBC do not form Rowlatt. Because of negative charge on them, they repel each other. But the patient is having multiple myeloma. So these abnormal plasma cells are forming abnormal globulin, which is excessive light chain, and this is positively charged. So excessively positively charged globulins are present inside the blood. These positively charged will neutralize the negative charge on the RBC. Now RBC will become neutral. Because the negative is neutralized by the positive. So neither negative nor positive is present on them. So once they become neutral, they will stuck with each other and they will form a train which is known as Rowlatt at tried hard. Give me a thumbs up. I deserve a thumbs up. Have you got it? What is the mechanism of Rowlatt formation? So that is the mechanism. So actually Rowlatt formation takes place because of increased positively charged protein formation. That is gamma globulin, which is formed in multiple myeloma. The positively charged protein, that is globulin, neutralizes the negative charge on the RBCs. So allow them to stack with each other. They stack with each other, they form a train of 4 or 5, and that is known as Rowlatt. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So that is Rowlatt formation. So based on this, three questions are clear. What it is Rowlatt formation. In which condition it is seen? It is seen in multiple myeloma. Why it is seen in multiple myeloma? The third question, because in multiple myeloma, abnormal globulin is formed, which is positively charged. It will neutralize the negative charge on the RBC and RBC clump with each other. Give me a thumbs up. Okay. So this is the next question in front of you. Easy one. I guess I can leave it. Name the test given here. Can you see a test tube here? Can you see a test tube? 0 to 10. Marking is 0 to 10 or 10 to 0. Reverse marking is also there. So this test tube is used for which test? Okay, mark it. It is an easy question. I have told you Nesterov test. It is not Nesterov test. Nesterov test means there should be a newspaper behind a test tube. It is not. It is not sickling test. It is not osmotic fragility test. It is ESR measurement. You all are right. Vikram, Kushi, Niveda. So ESR measurement is done in two test tubes. It is, what was the name of the tube? Two test tubes? Wintrobe. It is Wintrobe. You know the two test tubes. This is Wintrobe one because it is having 11 centimeter and it is having two markings, 0 to 10 and 10 to 0. So it is used for PSR measurement also. Okay, I'm skipping ahead. I'm done with hematology. Many questions from the hematology are done. In hematology, I covered maximum questions from anemia. I tried covering multiple questions from multiple anemias. I have shown you MAHA also. I have shown you sickle cell anemia also. I have shown you IDA also. I have shown you macroblastic, megaloblastic anemias also. Electrophoresis also. I have covered all possible questions from leukemia. I have covered all four leukemias. There is question, NHP's question from all four. ALL, AML, CLL, CML. I have given questions on multiple myeloma also. I have given questions on cells also, eosinophils, basophils, identify the cells. I have given questions on RBC inclusions, the five type of RBC inclusions, basophilic stippling, Hand's body, LJ, Howell-Jolly bodies, and Cabot rings, all of them. I have given the questions on various shapes of the RBCs, that is teardrop, elliptocytes, spherocytes, spur cells, burr cells, you know. So maximum hematology questions from these areas only. You will get a smear for anemia, you will get a smear for leukemia, you will get many questions on multiple myeloma smears or electrophoresis. Electrophoresis anemia may be important, and multiple myeloma may be important. RBC inclusions are important, RBC shapes are important. So these are the questions which can come from hematology. I'm not challenging that I had given you 40 questions yet now. 40 questions are done. 40 questions from hematology. So any question in your exam will be related to these image. So maximum questions will be exact this image or related to the concept. But concept is ki bahar nahi jayega, that I can guarantee. So in your hematology, these will be the concept. These are the areas which you have to pick up for your image-based question. You should know smear of all important anemias. I have covered it. I have covered it. You should know image of all four leukemias. I have covered lymphoma also, by the way. Lymphoma, Hodgkin's lymphoma pe questions aate hain aur as well. So I have covered that also. The various type of WBCs you should be identified. Eosinophil, basophil, neutrophil, based on the color of the granules. RBC inclusion, you can't skip it. RBC shape, you can't leave it. Done. Give me a thumbs up. So I'm coming on systemic pathology now. One by one, I will take the system and I will cover it. I will be a little bit fast now because it's 40 or 60 or we have to go ahead fast. Huh? So starting with the first system. So these are the systems I'm going to cover in systemic pathology. So I will start with CVS. After that, I will come on, I guess, GIT. After that, RESPI. After that, renal. After that, breast. After that, CNS. Then MGT, FGT. So that will be my sequence, okay, which is arranged in this PPT, that we will take it one by one. So I'm starting with CVS and blood vessels together. CVS and blood vessels, dono saath mein. Give me a thumbs up, everyone, everyone. You have to be fast enough, huh? So I'm starting with CVS, the first system, that is systemic pathology. And in the end, there are 15 images additional, which are from general pathology, which are from general. So next 45 images are from systemic, total 45 images, and last 15 images from general. So 40 plus 45 plus almost 15, so total 100 or 105 images I'm having, that I will cover here, that is from entire pathology. Coming on CVS, this is the first image in front of you, identify. Identified. Okay, I will launch it in the form of poll also. Identify. Easy question. Very easy. Who will tell me the correct answer? Which of the following is true about the image shown here? So is it monkey bug atherosclerosis? Is it hyaline arteriovenous sclerosis? Is it hyperplastic arteriovenous sclerosis? It is fibrinoid necrosis. Who will tell me? Khushi, Nivida, and Sweetie are first to answer it correctly. The correct answer is B. It is hyaline. It is hyaline. Can you see the blood vessel? Yes, you can see the lumen of two blood vessels here. I can see two blood vessels. In both of them, in the media, there are three layers, na, intima, media, externa. In the media, I can find a pink-colored acellular material filled in the media. So it is hyaline, which is filled in the media. So it is hyaline arteriosclerosis. I will give you the detail. Don't worry. One more question. After that, I will explain both of these together. One more question. It is hyaline. It is hyaline. Can you see the media, the pink-colored material, acellular material filled in the media of both of them? That's why it is hyaline. Give me a thumbs up. Next question. Next question. I will explain all three images. Don't worry. First, solve this question also. Then I will explain it. It is related. It is related. Which of the following is true? So see the image. You can see a blood vessel here. This is the intima. This is the media. See the media here now. See the media. Is it hyaline arteriosclerosis? Is it hyperplastic arteriosclerosis? Is it monkey bug atherosclerosis? Is it fibrinoid? Monkey bug mein calcium hona chahiye. I will show you an image for monkey bug also. Aayegi abhi aage. Monkey bug. Don't worry. Monkey bug bhi aayega. Tab yaad rakhna ye wala question. Monkey bug mein calcium hona chahiye. Deep blue color. No, it is not monkey bug. Hyaline mein pink color material hona chahiye. See the media here. See the media. I'm zooming it out. It is not pink homogeneous material. What you are looking here, you are looking smooth muscle cells are arranged like this. These all are smooth muscle cells in the media. They are arranged like this. So what is the arrangement? This arrangement is known as like onion skinning. You know onion ka chilka, pyaz ka chilka. Have you cut onion on some days? Yes, you may have cut. So if you see the onion, if you take the onion, the layers of the onion are concentric from inside. So it is looking like concentric here. So it is known as onion skinning. It is seen in hyperplastic arteriosclerosis. Typically, it is hyperplastic arteriosclerosis. So Karthik, Khushi and Manjusha are first to answer it correctly. Now see the first question. This was my first question. See the blood vessels here. See the media here. And see the blood vessel here. See the media here. Now I will explain you both these conditions. There are three type of changes which are seen in hypertension. Now, hypertension is of two types, benign and malignant. Benign hypertension is blood pressure less than less than benign is less than blood pressure less than 200 upon 120. If it is more than 200 upon 120, systolic and diastolic, it is known as malignant. So in benign hypertension, this is the blood vessel. These are the, okay, let me take another image. This is for benign hypertension. In benign hypertension, that is if blood pressure is less than 200 upon 120. So this is the scenario. And if malignant is there, these two are the scenario. In malignant hypertension, please learn it, benign or malignant. That will be the clue in the question. Question mein tumhe blood pressure likh denge. Patient is having blood pressure of this. So look at the blood pressure, whether it is in benign range or malignant range. So that will be the scene of the blood vessel in that person. Just suppose my blood pressure is less than more than 120 by 80, but less than 200 by 120. So I'm hypertensive, but in benign range. So if you see my blood vessel, that will be the scenario. So I will have hyaline arteriosclerosis. See the media in each of them. So intima is normal. This is the normal intima. See the media. Media is containing a pink colored acellular material that is known as hyaline. That's why known as hyaline arteriosclerosis. Give me a thumbs up. Now see the second diagram. See the media. This is the intima. See the media of this diagram. Here you can see smooth muscle cells are arranged in the form of the Onion skin, in the form of the concentric layers. This is known as hyperplastic. Why hyperplastic? Because smooth muscles are showing hyperplasia. Hyperplasia is cell number, increase in cell number. Hyperplastic arteriosclerosis. Hyperplastic, also known as Onion skin. Number two. Number three, see the third diagram. I have not put MCQ on this, but MCQ can come on this also. So here you can see the intima. In the media, you are seeing two things here. See, in the media, you are seeing neutrophils in the media. Please appreciate the neutrophils here. Neutrophils in the media. Can you see number of neutrophils in the media? So inflammation in the media, number one. And number two, can you see the pink colored, this pink colored dot 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 like material. This is necrosis. It is fibrinoid necrosis. So necrosis and inflammation together in the media. So necrotizing arteriolitis. Itis means inflammation. So as the name indicates, so there are three things in hypertension. So in hypertension, either hyaline arteriosclerosis or hyperplastic arteriosclerosis or necrotizing arteriolitis. So see the media of each of them. If media contains pink colored hyaline material, acellular material, it is this one. If media contains Onion skinning, smooth muscle cell, it is this one. If media contains neutrophils, and necrosis, it is this one. Give me a thumbs up. I tried hard. So these are the three types of hypertension. So I have covered question on two of them. Coming on the next question. So see, it is hyperplastic wall. You can see the Onion skinning. See, I'm coming on the next question. This is the next question. Tell me the diagnosis. Congo red is given, HNE is given. So 83-year-old male is there. This is the diagram of left ventricular myocardium. He's dead. We have done the autopsy. We have taken the heart out. Heart may left ventricular hypertrophy is there. So we have cut the left ventricle. It was vexy. And on Congo red, this is the color. Now see, on HNE, you can find something acellular pink in color, which is deposited between the cells. Can you see the acellular pink color thing here deposited? And on Congo red, the same thing become apple green color. What is the diagnosis? Write your diagnosis. Not in the chat box. It is not an MCQ. Write your diagnosis. What is your diagnosis? So something is there. Some material is there, which is pink color on HNE. And the same material become apple green color on Congo red. So typical diagnosis, Savita, Ushi, Vikram, you all are right. It is amyloid. Very important. If Congo red is given, it has to be amyloid. Yes, Manjusha. It is amyloidosis. So amyloidosis on HNE and amyloidosis on Congo red. These are the two stains. So on HNE, it looks pink in color. And on Congo red, it is green, apple green in color. So typical color. So both slides are given to you. In the first slide, both of them are extracellular. Try to see this extracellular pink color here. The same thing convert green color here. Please try to see this green color. Green color in this image. Jo wahan pe pink tha, wo yahan pe green ho gaya. So that is the thing. That is amyloidosis. Should I proceed? You should know the various. Now the same question, same image. I have changed the question. I have told you it is amyloid already in the question. I'm not asking you. It is amyloidosis. I have already told you that this is amyloid. What is the type? You tell me the type of amyloid. The options are in front of you. Is it AA amyloid? It is beta 2 microglobulin amyloid, or it is transthyretin? So I will launch the poll. You have four options. What is it? You should know all types of amyloid for your MCQs. Yes, who will tell me the type of the amyloid here? Khushi. I can't see the name of the second person. It is missing. And Chet. Our first to answer it correctly. Okay. let me do the correct answer here is transthyretin. Now see the age of the patient. He is an old patient with a left ventricular myocardium. That is the clue. It is amyloid. You should know all types of amyloid. These are the types of amyloid. If the patient is on dialysis, our patient is not on dialysis. Same image, answer will be beta 2 globulin. If in the question I add one line, patient is on dialysis, your answer will become beta 2 microglobulin. So trigger for beta 2 microglobulin is dialysis. It is not dialysis because our question mein dialysis nahi hai. Our question mein patient is senile and patient is having cardiac issue. So our answer is transthyretin. Our answer. So see the trigger in the question. Trigger in the question. Trigger is dialysis. Answer is beta 2 globulin. Trigger is senile. Patient is 83 year old and cardiac left ventricular hypertrophy is there. So it is senile cardiac amyloidosis. Answer is transthyretin. If the patient is having Alzheimer, in the same question, same image, if I add patient is having dementia, severe dementia, that is patient is having Alzheimer. So my answer will become A beta precursor. Give me a thumbs up. If the patient is having spongiform encephalopathy, patient is having prion disease. Give me a thumbs up. Fast. So that is the type. So next question in front of you. Be fast. This is the next question in front of you. Okay. Yes. So patient is thalassemic. Patient is having beta thalassemic. And he is killed. There was a female, 55 year old female is there having beta thalassemia. She is killed in a road traffic accident. After accident, I have taken the left ventricular myocardium. I have taken out the heart of the female. I have cut a slide of it and this is the slide. And this is HNE. What you can find here? So the clue in the question is thalassemia. Patient is having thalassemia. Thalassemic patient requires repeated blood transfusion. Repeated blood transfusion, thalassemic patients have excessive iron in their blood. The excessive iron get accumulated in the heart. It looks in the form of a brown color in the heart. Can you see the brown color in the heart? So the iron is deposited in the form of brown color pigment in the cells of the heart. This brown color pigment everywhere is hematin. It is iron. So it is secondary hematochromatosis. So excessive of iron, that is ferritin, is deposited in the heart. That is giving brown color here. It is not melanin. The brown color can be due to melanin, can be due to ferritin. Here the can be due to lipofuscin. So all of them will provide brown color to the cells. Yes, it is not melanin because the history should have melanoma, or melanin sort of black color hota. It is not brown. Lipofuscin was a tag, but it's seen in old age. It is 55. It's not old. Nahi hai. Lipofuscin nahi hoga. It will not lipofuscin. It is not amyloid. Amyloid look pink in color, not in brown. I have told you amyloid HNE pe pink color hota hai. Hypertension nahi hoga. It is not myocarditis. It is hematochromatosis. Hematochromatosis means excessive iron is there. Why patient is having excessive iron, excessive ferritin? Because of thalassemia, she is having repeated blood transfusion. And that is the cause of death in thalassemic patient. If the patient is having thalassemia major, uski wajah se nahi marega. Repeated blood transfusion dena padega, so excessive iron will be there. That will cause the damage of multiple organs, especially heart, and patient will be killed of that. Patient will be dead of that. Have you got it? The correct answer here is C. Why to see? Have you got it? Because the patient is thalassemic. Next question, spot diagnosis. It is a myocardium. Spot diagnosis, right? Yes, it is iron overload for the last question, Vijay. For this question, you tell me the diagnosis. What is the diagnosis? It is myocardium. Some abnormality in the myocardium. What is the abnormality? A collection of cells is seen here. You can see a collection of cells here. Something small collection of cells. This is abnormal in the myocardium. Apart from it, you can see cardiac muscles, you can see the striations, you can see the nucleus of the muscle. This is normal. This is all normal. This is abnormal. What is the abnormality? Write down the abnormality in the chat box if you can identify it. What is the abnormality here? Anyone? Can anyone tell me the abnormality? Yes or no? Write something. Now have your guesses. What is it? It is Chagas disease. Chagas disease can involve myocardium. It is trypanosoma cruzi. The small trypanosoma cruzi organism fill in the form of a cyst. Pseudocyst, and it can be seen. Can you see? This is trypanosoma cruzi. It is filled in the form of the cyst in the myocardium. So the myocardium here, you can see the organism. It is trypanosoma cruzi. Give me a thumbs up. It was a spotter. Give me a thumbs up. It is Chagas disease. Give me a thumbs up. The next question again a spotter. You can see the heart. See the heart. The patient is having sore throat and this heart, murmurs in the heart. Only this history is given. Patient is having murmurs and patient is having a history of sore throat. What is the diagnosis? I'm launching the poll. What is the diagnosis? You tell me the diagnosis. Who will tell me the diagnosis here? Fast. You have to be fast enough. So Khushi, Vikram Patel, you all are right. So this is a patent question from Robbins. It is repeated many times. In this diagram, you can see a heart wall. So it is heart wall. Why I identified as a heart wall? I can see cauda tendine here. This is cauda tendine, so it is a wall. On the wall, I can see the nodules. Can you see nodules? So these are vegetations. So vegetations on heart wall with a sore throat history, it is rheumatic fever, and answer has to be group A beta hemolytic infection. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone, give me a thumbs up. Should I proceed? It is an easy question. You can see the nodules. You can see the nodules here. It is a heart wall. It is left ventricle. See the thickness. It is a left ventricle. So left ventricle means it is mitral wall. It is a bicuspid wall. Try to see the two cusps. On it, you can see the multiple vegetations. Everyone, give me a thumbs up. So multiple vegetations on mitral wall with a sore throat history, it is rheumatic fever. It is rheumatic fever. Answer is A. So you already know what is rheumatic fever. I'm not explaining the details. In rheumatic fever, in the heart walls, vegetations are formed. Vegetations are formed in the heart wall. You can see these are the vegetations giving the fish mouth appearance, nodular appearance. So I'm moving ahead. I'm moving to the next question. This is the next question in front of you. Spotter, write your diagnosis in the chat box. I've not put the options. Two images are given to you. Elderly male is there with high ESR. Only question. High ESR, elderly male. Two images are there. One is temporal reason. You can see a artery here, which is dilated in the temporal reason. Here, a artery which is dilated. And biopsy of this artery is shown here. Biopsy of this artery is showing you multiple giant cells, multiple granulomas. Please zoom it out and try to see the granulomas. It is a giant cell. Can you see multiple nucleus? It is a giant cell. So multiple giant cells with multiple granulomas. Typical diagnosis. You can see this is intima. This is all media. Media is showing granulomas. Granulomas. Inflammation. And external is not shown. So that is an artery. So typical diagnosis. Who will tell me the diagnosis? Savita, Patel, Dashrath, Vikram and Khushi. You all are right. The correct answer, it is giant cell arthritis. It is giant cell arthritis, also known as temporal arthritis. Yes or no? So typical image, typical question, typical answer. Done. So here temporal artery is involved. So in the temporal artery, there is inflammation. Not only temporal artery, external carotid artery ki branches. External carotid artery, one of the arteries is temporal artery. Other arteries, ophthalmic artery can also be involved. It can lead to blindness, the deadly complication of this disease. And it can involve vertebral artery also. So temporal, ophthalmic, vertebral, all can be involved. Most commonly, temporal is involved. So typical complaint, patient will say, I'm having headache here. In this portion, segmental, I'm having typical headache. If you palpate the artery here, you can see the artery is thickened here. The artery is thickened here in the temporal region. If you biopsy that artery, this is the diagnosis. In the biopsy, you will see multiple granulomas, granulomatous inflammation in the artery. So it is giant cell, because giant cells are seen. Giant cell arthritis, also known as temporal arthritis. So giant cell arthritis, temporal artery is involved. Sometimes ophthalmic artery is involved. It will lead to permanent blindness. Permanent patient will become blind. So start steroid immediately. Start steroid the first time. Start steroid. Otherwise, patient can turn blind at any moment. So start steroid. The treatment is this time need PG, jo 12 September ko thi, jiska result kal aaya hai, usme ye question tha. So treatment, the question was on treatment, you know, steroids pe question tha, you know, if you have given it. So that is the question. Should I proceed ahead? Okay. This is the next question in front of you. This is the next question. There is a 70-year female having suddenly dyspneic and lethargic. So left ventricular hypertrophy, left ventricular failure. Dyspnea hai aur lethargy hai. So it is left ventricular. Dyspnea is due to pulmonary edema. And lethargy because blood is not moving ahead in the aorta. So left ventricular failure with hypertension. And see the MI, see the myocardium. The image of the myocardium is given to you. So what marker you will do to confirm your diagnosis? There are five options. So mark your correct answer. What diagnosis, what investigation you will do to make your diagnosis? See the image. Make your diagnosis. First make your diagnosis what the patient is having. So you all are right, Savita, Khushi, Patel, the correct answer here is CKMB. You will do CKMB. If the option contains troponin, I was much happy. But if the option is not containing troponin, I will go with CKMB. So CKMB is the second best marker for MI. The diagnosis here is MI. Why? Why the diagnosis here is MI? Here I can see a myocardium. In the myocardium, I can't see the striations. I can see only pink color acellular material, that is necrosis. It is coagulative necrosis all around. I can't see normal myocardium. You should know how normal myocardium looks like. So there are alternate light dark bands, striations are there. I can't find nucleus, I can't find cytoplasm, I can't find striations. I can find only pink color material, that is necrosis. So it is showing coagulative necrosis. So of course it is MI. In MI, this is the image. So this is the MI, this is MI. And in MI, the investigation of choice is troponin. Troponin is not given in the option, so I will go with CPK-MP. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So based on the question, based on the image, make the diagnosis. After making the diagnosis, look at the options. This is the approach. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So the correct answer here is B. Coming to the next question, correct answer here is B. Coming to the next, you know, in MI, there are multiple, there are 10 zones. So all zones will have separate image. You already know the images in separate zone. First, there is waviness. Then there is mild inflammation by the neutrophils. Then there is brisk inflammation by the neutrophils. Then neutrophil decrease and macrophage will arise. And then there will be necrosis, fibrosis, and scarring is there. So various stages are there. These are the five enzymes which we see in blood. Most specific is troponin. But if troponin is not there, go for CPK-MB. So in our question, CPK-MB was there in the option. I'm not giving the detail as the time is limited. Look at the image. Don't read the question. Look at the image, spotter. Spotter. What is shown in the image? There are five options. There are five options. So look at the image. Look at the blood vessels. This is intima. This is media. What is seen in the media? What is seen in the media? In the blood vessel. Spotter. Don't read. Question aise bade bade tumhe denge exam mein for wasting your time. Sometimes question is not at all important. So read the option. See the image. Then read the question in short. So question mein ye diya hai ki 72-year female have a lump in the neck. So thyroid was there. Subtotal thyroidectomy is done. So can you see the thyroid here? So we have made the slide of the thyroid. But incidental finding is the blood vessel. Thyroid with the goiter is there. Okay, it is there. So we were suspecting goiter, it is there. But incidental finding, something we found here in the blood vessel. Can you see here? Can you see here? Something blue color is there in the blood vessel. Media, deep, dark, purple, blue color. Something is there in the media. It is calcium deposition in the media. It is known as Monkey Bug Atherosclerosis. Khushi, Karthik and Manjusha are first to answer it correctly. So it is Monkey Bug. So it is calcium deposition in the media which look deep blue or basophilic in color. So it is always incidental finding. It will not cause any. Maybe it is present inside me, inside you, but it is symptomless. So sometimes we get operated for some other reason and incidental finding will be the monkey bug. So the pathologist will say, okay, you have goiter, but you also have monkey bug atherosclerosis. So that is the incidental finding. Give me a thumbs up. So monkey bug is a spotter. It will be a blood vessel. The intima is normal. In the media, you will see blue color spots in the media. It is dark blue basophilic spots. It is monkey bug atherosclerosis, calcium deposition in the media. It is symptomless. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So my time, the second, this lecture is also, link is expiring. Okay, let me see the next question. Okay, this is the next question. Okay, we will continue from this question in the next lecture. So just after 10 minutes at 11:30 sharp, 11:30 sharp. So there is a break for 10 minutes. After that, we will join again episode number 3. Join IBQ Marathon. Episode number 3, marathon episode number 3. So we will continue it from 11:30. Refresh yourself, have a cup of coffee and come back. Come back. We will continue it and we will try to do as much as possible till end. I will cover at least complete system. So I will continue my marathon. So I'm ending this lecture. Don't go anywhere. Come back, everyone.